What exactly, Liam was just touching on this, but just to confirm all of this, what exactly are the 1967 borders? What would Israel be giving up if they were to go along with some kind of peace agreement along the lines of what President Obama has just suggested? Well, in short, they would be giving up a lot, including many sacred and historical sites like the Western Wall, or the Wailing Wall as it is known, in Hebrew as the Kotel. It is the only remaining wall from the Jewish temple, and folks around the world come to leave notes to God in it, as you have seen them doing over the years. The Pope has visited that very historic spot as well and put notes into the Wailing Wall, as it's called. Also, the Tower of David, believed to be King David's palace, is within that area. The Church of the Holy Sepulchre, which is the church that is built on the traditional site of Jesus' crucifixion and burial site. And Mount Olives, the place Jesus entered Jerusalem during the last week of his life, it is a very significant holy Jewish site, and it is considered a sacred burial ground. So some, you know, huge, important landmarks within those territories that are being discussed right now.
Truly, this is a war in the making. All the ingredients have been added to the mixing pot. Once the timer goes off, the powder keg will explode. When the General Assembly votes, the Obama administration has already said that the United States will veto the vote. In the event Palestine becomes a state, and its statehood is recognized, the Third World War will break forth. The dividing of Jerusalem will cause major havoc worldwide. It is a no-win situation for the United States. If she stands with Israel, she will be attacked by China, Russia, and Germany. In the event the United States turns its back on the State of Israel, the nation will be ripped into. As you see, all who will not stand with the State of Israel will be cursed. Before deciding whom you will stand with, remember there is a big difference in that State of Israel and Israel the people. Getting these two confused could very well cost you your life. Never forget that Yahushua said,
"My reign is not of this world. If my reign were of this world, my servants would fight, so that I should not be delivered to the Yehudim. But now my reign is not from here."
Yahushua speaks two important key points that are essential for you to comprehend. First, let us note that he tells us his kingdom is not of this world. If his kingdom is not of this world, then it must be of another earth age. We are also told,
"The heaven and the earth shall pass away, but my words shall by no means pass away."
As you see, all who will not stand with the State of Israel will be cursed. Before deciding whom you will stand with, remember, there is a big difference in the State of Israel and Israel the people. The second issue is found in the second half of that verse, "For if my kingdom was of this world, my followers would fight for me." What he is telling us is that since his kingdom is clearly of another earth age, his followers will not fight. They will also not enlist in the upcoming false Armageddon. This has nothing to do about being a pacifist, but everything they do following after the Messiah Yahushua. Taking all this into consideration, I humbly ask you to carefully ponder on just whom you will stand with. Do not be deceived into the up and coming planned Armageddon. I speak a truth, this is a very dangerous deception. The pressure will be turned up to the fullest. Will you stand with God's army and fight for the Holy Land, or will you be on the side of Satan? I am reminded of a very important verse.
"Woe to those who call evil good, and good evil. Who put darkness for light, and light for darkness. Who put bitter for sweet, and sweet for bitter." Isaiah 5:20. "For whoever wishes to save his life shall lose it, and whoever loses his life for my sake shall find it." Matthew 16:25. Every nation and individual that supports the plan to curse Israel and steal from her the land God promised the Jews as an eternal possession will suffer his chastisement and judgment. Every nation and individual that opposes this plan and stands with Israel as a blessing to her will enjoy his blessing. That is why we have launched a national campaign to rally opposition to the Obama administration's plan to expose the anti-Semitism that lies behind world efforts to curse Israel and to support the Jewish people. Your gift today to bless Israel is urgently needed. Curse on any nation that touches Jerusalem. Once before, an American president attempted to divide Jerusalem and surrender the Temple Mount to radical Islam. That president was Bill Clinton. Now, President Obama plans to do the same. This time, by formally recognizing a Palestine state at the UN, in September, within days of the 10th anniversary of the 9/11 attacks.
They truly believe that whoever does not stand with the state of Israel will be cursed. This is very dangerous, as previously covered, there is a difference between the state of Israel and the people of Israel. The big kicker is that once the state of Israel is divided, the United States, along with all nations around the world, will crumble to their knees. Either way, the United States will be involved in the planned Armageddon. In the event the U.S. agrees with the Palestinians over the 1967 border conditions or not, the U.S. will be dragged into the planned Armageddon. In the event the U.S. does agree with the Palestinians, the U.S. will be totally broken. We could very well see the economic system crash. With the help of HARP, the nation will literally be split in two, both physically and spiritually. You see, the common belief is, anyone who does not stand with Israel will be cursed by God. This is true, however. Ponder, just who is Israel? Is it a people, or a land? It is a people. All any of us can do is sit back and watch it unfold before our eyes. This planned war could span out over weeks, months, maybe years. Once it grows in momentum, reaching the climax, the imposter will show up. All nations will be called up to draw the line in the sand, such as China, Russia, Egypt, Syria, Iran, Lebanon, and Germany, against the state of Israel. Once this occurs, we will be even closer to the staged arrival of the imposter. During this time, however, natural, along with man-made calamities will occur. We will be entering into the last few moments of Earth as we know it. Indeed, great chaos will be upon this world. The entire global economic system will crash, while food prices and home energy soar. Gas prices could very well go up to as high as $5 to $10 per gallon. The plot thickens with all these doomsday events, such as the Elenium dwarf star, Planet X, 2012, the Mayan calendar. They are all smoke screens. This is fear-mongering at its best. Sadly, many are indeed being induced with great fear. Stay awake, and stay focused as Yahushua has told us to. Listen to him. Once Jerusalem is split up, the planned Armageddon will break forth. This is what you need to watch for. Satan will get its 15 minutes of global spotlight. This is the strong delusion that Yahushua has warned you about. Take heed, beloved ones, do not be deceived by the coming illusion. When reading the book of Revelation, we learn that there are two major earthquakes of great importance mentioned. Despite hundreds of earthquakes going off worldwide, only two will cause catastrophic, unimaginable devastation. Let us compare these verses side by side.
And I looked when he opened the sixth seal, and saw a great earthquake came to be. And the sun became black as sackcloth of hair, and the moon became as blood. Revelation 6:12. And the seventh messenger poured out his bowl into the air, and a loud voice came out of the dwelling place of the heaven, from the throne, saying, "It is done." And there came to be noises and thunders and lightnings. And there came to be a great earthquake, such a mighty and great earthquake as had not came to be since men were on the earth. And the great city became divided into three parts, and the cities of the nations fell. And great Babel was remembered before Elohim, to give her the cup of the wine of the fierceness of his wrath. And every island fled away, and the mountains were not found. And great hail from the heaven fell upon men, every hailstone about the weight of a talent. And men blasphemed Elohim for the plague of the hail, because that plague was exceedingly great. Revelation 16:17-21.
Clearly, there are two distinct earthquakes. One occurs at the sixth seal, while the other occurs at the seventh trumpet. There is no possible way Yahushua shows up at the sixth seal because he makes his triumphant return when the seventh bowl is poured, the seventh trumpet is blown and the seventh seal opened. The seventh trumpet blows at the very end of this earth age. To say the earthquake that occurs at the sixth seal is actually the second coming of Yahushua is extremely erroneous. Brothers and sisters, Yahushua is not coming back two more times, just the one time. At his return, Mount Olives will be split in two. As previously noted, the imposter, with the help of harp, will counterfeit many of the prophetic prophecies of the second coming of Yahushua. In order for the entire world to fall for the coming strong delusion, the imposter has to counterfeit the verses. Let us just examine one of these prophecies found in the great book of Zechariah.
And in that day, his feet shall stand upon the Mount of Olives, which faces Jerusalem on the east. And the Mount of Olives shall be split in two, from the east to west, a very great valley, and half of the mountain shall move toward the north and half of it toward the south. Zechariah 14:4.
How can the impostor duplicate such a massive deception of producing one of the most significant earthquakes throughout all history? Let's face it, to convince the entire world that Jesus just landed on Mount Olives, something powerful and great is gonna have to take place. With modern-day technology, man can do just that. That's right, man has managed to create just the tool to invoke harsh weather conditions, along with causing massive earthquakes. This technology is called HERP. This mean machine being held in the Illuminati's hands will produce an earthquake so massive, that it will literally convince the world Jesus has arrived. What we should find very interesting is that one of the strongest and most powerful fault lines runs right through the Valley of Megiddo. There is also a fault line that runs directly through modern-day Jerusalem. Even more fascinating is that there is a major fault line that runs right through the Mount of Olives. This fault line runs from Mount Olives to the Kidron Valley, through the Valley of Hinnom, and follows the Kidron Brook, and then empties into the Dead Sea. Man will easily be able to move these global tectonic plates with electromagnetic waves, causing a massive earthquake. Yet, the strongest quake to wobble the entire world will occur at the seventh trump when the true Messiah Yahushua shows up, as outlined in the Imposter documentary and this film, right at the climax of the planned, the false Armageddon, the Imposter, shows up ushering in the strong delusion. Yahushua does not show up until the seventh and last trumpet. When Yahushua shows up at the seventh trumpet, the earthquake, along with the super volcanoes, the earth will have to be renewed. However, do not get this time confused with the great day of Yahuwah, which takes place at the end of the 1,000 years, as outlined in Revelation 21:14. We here at the FOY Ministry hope you have been greatly blessed by this film, The False Armageddon. Our desire is that you will share this information with others. May we all stay awake and not fall for the coming strong delusion.